Welcome back to The Campus Life. My name is Sally Satole, and thank you so much for joining us. And today, the lady I have in studio is a mother, a wife, a two-time graduate, and recently released a single. Interesting, right? I know. Bongie, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you so much for having me, Sally.
It is quite a pleasure. I mean, your story is quite inspirational. There was no way but to have you in the studio.
Thank you so much.
Indeed, so that the other ladies, other women who are married and who have kids can also be like, you know, if she can do it, I can also do it.
Oh, it's doable.
But I think let's first start by you telling me about yourself. Who are you? Where do you come from?
Okay, my name is Bongile Umahudla.
Okay.
Who now goes by Hlongwane. And I was born in Johannesburg. I grew up here, but my family is originally from Ulundi. Okay. So ngintombi yasolundi, intombi yomZulu.
KZN?
KZN, okay. North KZN.
All right. So you are a two-time graduate, but I want you to walk me through you moving from KZN, moving to Johannesburg to pursue your studies and let's start with that.
Okay, so like I said, originally from KZN, my family, my mom and my dad moved to Johannesburg, you know, to pursue work,
yeah.
You know, and that's why I was born here and I studied here and graduated in comprehensive programming. Only to find that, you know, when you finish school,
yeah,
there's that peer pressure, you know, the friends you acquaint yourself with, you realize that, no, I should not have done that.
Yeah.
Or it wasn't me. It's not my passion. But I did it just because everyone was doing it. Mm. But anyway, I did it. I graduated and never even got a job in that space, you know. I ended up getting a job in sales, of which I loved so much. You know, you never underestimate any job that you're doing because you learn new things every day. It taught me to understand people, you know, to work under pressure and all those things. So I'm grateful for that opportunity.
So how many years were you in the sales industry?
More than 10 years.
More than 10 years?
More than 10 years.
So you went to school for how many years?
3 years.
3 years, then yes. You worked in sales for more than 10 years?
Correct.
And then what happened? Like what was that awakening to say, let me go back to school? What happened with that?
Okay, so I'll start here. So I got married in the year 2015.
Mm-hmm.
And shortly thereafter, I was pregnant with my son.
Yeah.
And I think I was about 6-7 months pregnant, and then I resigned because the pressure was too much.
Yeah.
I couldn't cope, and it was taking its toll on me. So I had to rest a bit, you know. Sometimes you just have to tone it a bit down. So I left the sales space and, yes, had my son. And that's how it all began. And then I started thinking to myself that, no, man, this is not all that there could be to me.
And then you decided to go back to school.
My husband actually pushed me.
Yeah.
My husband and my parents. You know, they said to me, no, you love this. You love the news. You love watching you love current affairs and discussing it. And it's always, when they come in, visitors come in, it's always on the news channel. And the way you talk, you know, that's what comes out of your mouth the whole time. So why don't you pursue this? And my husband said, no, you need to go back. Do what you love. You know, so do the things you love. You're not stuck. Marriage is not the end. You know, do what you love and I'll support you. And that's how it all came about.
You know, a lot of women who have children, who are married and settled, I think majority of them, once they settle, they tend to forget their dreams, right? Mm. But you went for your dreams, even though you had those kind of responsibilities, married, having children, and decided to go back to school, right? But what are some of the challenges that you had faced with the decision that you took to say, hey, let's go back to school now?
You know, Sally, before you get married, you're in the comfort of home.
Yeah.
You know, you've got your mom or your dad, you've got your sister, you've got, there's always somebody that's going to do something, somebody that's going to clean the house and do the dishes. You don't always have to do it. You know, you can just push it to someone else. And then you get married, you move into your own home. That's your responsibility, yourself and your spouse. So I was fortunate in that I got married to someone who is not helping me, but is doing his part, is doing what he's supposed to do, like I am.
Yeah.
So we're not helping one another. You know, we're all doing our bit to make sure that the household runs smoothly.
Mm.
So that's how I could manage it. That's how it worked. And also when I was supposed to study, he understood. And I've been so blessed, and my kids as well, they understood. You know, when mommy's studying, we try not to, you know, instead we assist her, you know, as young as they are. They would sit with me, ask mommy, what can we help you with?
Mm.
You know, so I use that to my advantage.
I like that. But Bongie, your story is so inspirational. I mean, when did you matriculate? I think just so for someone who's listening, like, hey, actually, I'm not too old to go back. You know, I still have the energy. But
right.
When did you matriculate?
So I matriculated in the year 2000.
In the year 2000?
2000.
You don't want to know where I was by then.
I should say you were not around at that time.
I don't know. But you matriculated in 2000, decided to go in IT, and then graduated, went into sales for more than 10 years.
Right.
Then you decided to go back to schools for another 3 years.
Right.
And then you graduated. After graduating, what happened?
Oh, after graduating, I sat down and I said to myself, what are the things that you love to do?
Mm.
You know, at home, growing up with my parents and my siblings, I would sing the whole time.
Yeah.
I would literally bother everyone when I was washing dishes, when I was taking a shower, when I was sweeping the yard, cleaning. I would basically sing. Even when my siblings were studying, I would sing, you know, and they'd be like, oh, we're trying to study and whatnot. So everything I had to sing. You know, I loved singing, and I thought to myself, well, I know I could, you know.
Yeah.
So I thought to myself, I can't be pouring from an empty cup the whole time. You know, I need to do things that I love, you know, be it singing or journalism or whatnot. And I decided to pursue the singing. I said, I love this. And if I'm doing this, I'll never feel like I'm working, you know. And that's how it all came. I said, I'm going to do this. I did the studying with my children, you know. I graduated. Why can I not do this?
And you went into the music industry.
That's right.
And right now you have a single.
Yay.
Yes. Okay. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
But tell me, what is the name of the single? What is it all about? What is the inspiration behind the single?
Okay. So the name of the song is Kunje.
Okay.
And the inspiration behind it is someone who's been trying, you know, to make it, but not knowing where to start. You know, when you want something, but you don't know where to go, who to go to, how to go about it. So that's how it is when you get to Joburg. You know, it's a mixture of cultures. Everyone is doing this, the same thing, basically. It's oversaturated. The music industry, I could say, is oversaturated. And I thought to myself, how can I make a difference? How can I make my mark? You know, I just thought I'm going to be myself. And the song talks about someone who makes it in the end, you know, trying and not stopping. You know, you have to, crawling if you need to, but you don't stop. You keep on dreaming. Do not let go of your dreams. You know, nothing is impossible. As long as you start, you know, it's going to happen. So I started, and I did not have to be great to do it. And I'm on my way there.
I like it. So the song is a resemblance of your life journey.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. So I'm living the song. You know, I'm doing what I love, and it was not easy. I did not know where to start, but in the end, because I wanted it so much, I made it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go to the studio, right? I wish I was there. The first day when you were recording your single, take me through the emotions, take me through the creativity. What happened in the studio?
So it was so natural. I went into the studio, and the producer of the song, Ola, started playing the beat.
Yeah.
You know, and it was so organic. As soon as he started, I listened, I closed my eyes and said, no, man, you know, and I started singing.
Yeah.
You know, and he looked at me and he said, that's it.
Yeah.
That's it. That's the route that we're taking with
the
song.
So you didn't write anything?
We did not write anything. We just went with it, and the song was born.
Now, Bongie, you are a mother, you're a wife. How are you balancing the career, now the music and the family? How are you balancing all of that?
Well, in my situation, I thought to myself, I'm going to make everything around me work to my advantage. You know, a supportive husband, you know, children who understand what I'm doing. You know, children are very smart. You need to explain to them, you know, and they'll understand. We underestimate them. So they understand what I'm doing. So I explained to them. We sing along, you know, both my kids know the song. So we sing along, they understand what I'm doing. You know, we went through, they downloaded it on their phones also. So, and a supportive husband, I've got my mom, you know, she's there. So it's all working together, and because I want to do it, I'm not going to let anything stop me from doing it. I'm going to do this, you know. I've accomplished what I've accomplished because I stood up and said I can do this.
Yeah, you know, speaking about your husband, and the song, right? So when you went to him and told him that actually I want to release a single or do something, how was his reaction when you came with the news that actually I think I might, you know, put my foot in the music industry?
So he wasn't surprised, because he had been also telling me about it. He'd been pushing. I sing all the time. I don't know if my neighbor, if you maybe interviewed my neighbors, they're like, she's always singing and with the music and whatnot. So he knew. So he was like, you know, do this, go for it. I'm here. Let me support you. How can I support you? And that's the most important thing. Support structure is vital.
I love that. You know, actually, when you told me that you released this song, before I listened to the song, I actually thought that it was going to be something revolving around love. Maybe that you've been hurt. Because I think that's a lot of songs revolve around love and so forth. So maybe can we expect this kind of that kind of song maybe in future in the album or anything?
absolutely. Positivity, spreading positivity. You know, that's what our people need. You know, they need to see that, no man, this girl did it. How did she, why can't I? What is so special about her? Nothing was special about me. I stood up and I did it. So definitely in the pipeline, a lot of songs that uplift you, that you can listen to anytime and be like, yeah.
But what's going to be the driving force of that love song that's going to come up?
Is there something
that you've experienced?
Well, I mean, I'm in love since established officially in 2015.
Congratulations. It's been how many years now? Eight, nine years?
It's going for nine now. Yeah. So that will come very easy. Very easy. I've got a lot of that in the pipeline coming. So not difficult at all.
Smooth. Not any song about any ex maybe somewhere?
I don't think they deserve my airtime.
Yeah. Ooh, okay. All right. No,
they need to
that.
Stay there in the past.
Yeah, I like that. Okay, but like I'm quite interested. Why wouldn't you want to give them airtime? I mean, they were such, I believe they played such a big role in your life. So
absolutely. They played a very big role in that they taught me what is acceptable and unacceptable.
Okay.
They taught me what I needed. They showed me what I needed to get in order to be where I am. Because if I was still with that person, I wouldn't be where I am right now. I'd be stuck, you know, I'd be at the bottom.
Yeah.
I don't know, hey?
What happened? It's like it's an interesting story. What happened?
Ooh.
Tell me.
Okay, so you had to go there.
I had to. You know why? Because recently there has been people talking on Twitter about the big weekend that was happening in Limpopo. So if you know a guy friend or your boyfriend was traveling to Limpopo or so forth, they were getting married because they were wearing traditional, you know. So maybe it's related to that. I don't know. But I'm quite intrigued about your story. Why wouldn't you want to go there?
Sally, that is basically what happened to me.
For real? The same story?
It's similar.
Okay.
So I was with this person.
Okay. All right, what happened?
So I was with this person. You're with this person, say, on a Monday.
Yeah.
And they get married the Saturday.
What?
That's basically what happened to me.
How did you find out?
I found out from, you know, I would say friends told me, and yeah. I was in denial. I don't know, man. And I thought they were joking or jealous, or why would he do that? I was in love. I wouldn't say we were in, I was in love, you know. And only to find out that he really was getting married.
Wow.
And the Saturday, in that same week I was with him, he was getting married.
Oh, my goodness.
And I was shattered, Sally.
I can imagine.
It almost broke me. This is a person I thought we're going to get married, have kids, and only to find out that he's doing it with someone else. I won't lie to you. I was shattered. Mm. And you haven't arrived if you haven't gone through heartbreak. That's what I always say. If you haven't gone through heartbreak, you don't know what to expect, or what you want, or what you need in your life, and what you don't. You know, if you haven't gone through heartbreak, well, congratulations. Well done.
Yeah.
You know, keep it like that. But that's what happened to me.
Yeah, I guess we'll be expecting a hot fire single of a love song coming soon with this kind of story. But I'm sorry about what you went through. But let's talk about your future aspirations, your goals in the music industry. Are we expecting an album? Are we expecting an EP? What should we look up for?
Sally, definitely an EP in the pipeline.
Okay.
You know, so many stories to tell, real stories, you know, that's what people need out there. Real stories, something that they can relate with, you know, not some unrealistic, you know. So that's what's coming in the pipeline. I want staying power in the music industry, not just for the sake of it, but to share and empower.
I like that. Mm-hmm. I like that. And now, finally, what advice would you give to women in the same train with you, who are married, who have children, and maybe some who have neglected their dreams to say, you know what, this is time consuming, I can't pay attention to my dreams. But you have, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
You have, you went and reached your goals and your success with both your hands. But what advice would you give to women in that case?
Sally, you cannot pour from an empty cup. Work on yourself. Look after yourself. Work on your dreams. Don't just dream about it. Work on your dreams. As a woman, stand up. You know, do something. You know, don't be in a corner. You don't belong in the kitchen. You know, you don't belong in some corner. You know, stand up. Do it for yourself. Don't allow anyone to put you down. And always go for what you want for. That is how you are going to be a great example to your children, to your husband. You need to take the lead. Your spouse needs to see that. No, this is what she wants. And when she wants it, she goes for it. And your spouse needs to be there to support. Support can not only be one way. It needs to be, you know, two way. You support one another. That's how you build something strong and something solid. And that's how you inspire your kids. You know, your kids look at you and be like, this is what I want in future. And they won't settle for anything. You know, they become strong citizens.
I like that. Okay, so where can we find you on social media, and where can we find your music?
Okay, so it's Bongie with an E at the end, B-O-N-G-I-E-H, Bongie_HSA, that's Instagram, Bongie_HSA, that's TikTok, and Bongie H-S-A, that is Facebook.
Okay, and your music?
It's Kunje. You'll find it on all digital stores. Available. Download, stream. You'll be inspired.
Oh, I'm definitely loving this. Thank you so much for joining us today in studio. Your story is really inspirational. And ladies and gentlemen, this is where we leave it for today, The Campus Life. My name is Sally Sithole. And with a few minutes that is remaining, please listen to the song. And while we're at it, don't forget to subscribe, share, and press that notification button so that you do not miss out any episode that's coming out next. Until I see you next time, goodbye. Mama.
The University of Johannesburg, the future reimagined.